Hello, my name is David Kilzer, and I'm a Microsoft Specialist Solutions Architect here at Amazon Web Services. In this video, I will cover OpenTelemetry and code-first instrumentation of a .NET 8 web application to send traces to AWS X-Ray. First off, what is observability and instrumentation? Observability and instrumentation are crucial concepts in modern software development. Observability allows us to gain insights into a system's behavior and performance without delving into its intricate inner workings. To achieve observability, applications must be properly instrumented using libraries, emitting signals such as traces, metrics, and logs. An application is considered well instrumented when developers have access to all the necessary information to troubleshoot issues. OpenTelemetry is an open-source, vendor-agnostic observability framework that has emerged as the Cloud Native Computing Foundation's second most popular project. It was created to address the lack of a standard for instrumenting code and sending telemetry data to an observability backend. It allows you to instrument your applications once, collect and aggregate telemetry data, and seamlessly send it to multiple destinations. Designed as a cloud-centric framework, OpenTelemetry supports multiple programming languages, providing flexibility and scalability for monitoring your distributed systems in today's cloud-native world. The purpose of OpenTelemetry is to collect, process, and export signals. Signals are system outputs that describe the underlying activity of your applications. Signals are composed of traces, metrics, logs, and baggage. Traces provide visibility into the entire journey, allowing you to understand what happens during requests made by or to your application, which is great for distributed systems. Metrics offer real-time insights into performance and health of your services by capturing measurements at runtime. For example, you can record and capture the number of clicks or API requests made. Logs provide timestamp text records with metadata, offering a detailed chronological record of events. Baggage enables the propagation of contextual information across distributed traces, ensuring data is passed seamlessly between spans during a trace. And then finally, the OpenTelemetry protocol standardizes the way telemetry data is transmitted, enabling seamless integration with observability tools. AWS provides the AWS distribution for OpenTelemetry, or ADOT, a secure, production-ready open-source distribution of OpenTelemetry. This upstream-first distro is certified by AWS for security and predictability, ensuring a stable and reliable user experience. With AWS support backing it, ADOT offers one-click deployment and configuration from AWS Container and AWS Lambda consoles, streamlining the implementation process. Additionally, it provides exporters for various AWS monitoring solutions, including Amazon CloudWatch, AWS X-Ray, Amazon OpenSearch Service, Amazon Managed Prometheus, and partner solutions, enabling seamless integration with your existing monitoring infrastructure. OpenTelemetry was created to standardize instrumenting code and sending telemetry data to an observability backend. In the simple reference architecture, an application is instrumented with OpenTelemetry to send signals to the AWS distribution for OpenTelemetry, or ADOT, collector. The ADOT collector has three components: the receiver, exporter, and processor. The receiver is responsible for receiving signals from one or more sources through gRPC or HTTP using the OpenTelemetry protocol. The processor takes data collected by receivers and transforms it before sending it to the exporter. Then the exporters send data to one or more backends like AWS X-Ray, Amazon Managed Prometheus, or Jaeger. For .NET applications, OpenTelemetry provides native libraries to add to your projects. These packages allow you to instrument your application and export signals to the OpenTelemetry collector or other destinations like the console for testing and debugging. After you instrument your application, you configure the collector by defining receivers, processors, and exporters in the configuration file. You then enable these components by defining a pipeline under the services block. In this example, we're receiving traces from OpenTelemetry protocol on port 4317. We are running a batch processor to export our signals in batches instead of one by one as they come in. And then for our exporter, we're exporting to AWS X-Ray with the region configured as US East 1. This code configures OpenTelemetry for this ASP.NET Core application by registering a singleton service and setting up tracing. It initializes OpenTelemetry with a specific service name and version, enabling tracing for HTTP requests and client calls. The tracing data is exported to both the console for local debugging and an external OpenTelemetry collector endpoint for further analysis. We also register a custom instrumentation class as a singleton for custom telemetry purposes. This is the custom instrumentation class, which will hold a reference to our activity source. Activity sources are used for creating and managing telemetry data for distributed tracing. So here's the configuration we're going to use for our ADOT collector. We're going to receive traces on port 4317 using the OpenTelemetry protocol. We're going to use a batch processor to send our traces over in batches. Then for our exporter, we'll send our traces to AWS X-Ray with the region configured for US East 1. So here we have the home controller. We have the outgoing HTTP method. So what this is going to do is make a call to aws.com and return the website contents as a string, but also instrument that request and add a couple of custom tags that we can attach to our traces. So here we have our Docker compose file. What this will allow us to do is run our application as a container, as well as the ADOT collector as a container in a sidecar configuration. This will allow us to generate traces and then pass those to the collector for processing and exporting. We're also authenticating and configuring our collector to use the AWS CLI credentials, which I have configured on my local machine, as well as configuring the region and pulling in the configuration file from our local computer into the container. So here we have the application running. We'll run our outgoing HTTP method, which creates a HTTP request to aws.com, which returns the website as a HTML string. So here we are in the CloudWatch console looking at our X-Ray traces. As you can see from the trace map, traces are correctly being exported to AWS X-Ray. So we can click on one of these and dive deeper into the request. As you can see, the GET request that we created going to aws.com traced successfully. And here we can dive in to get more details, such as the duration of the trace, as well as the response codes. And if we click on metadata, we can see the custom tags we added to our manual trace.
I hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching.